is the value stream design. This is a design guidelines to create energy efficiency production processes. Here are the eight guidelines. The first guideline that I'd like to pay attention to is manufacturing at an optimal operating point. And we'll see an example of how this is calculated. The second guideline that I want to focus on is reducing energy demand from resources by technical improvements. The more traditional approach, that is to say. The third guideline is minimizing the energy consumption of the resources during standby operation. This is an opportunity to do smart controls. The fifth guideline that I'd like to illustrate with an example today is energy recovery, in particular, heat energy recovery. So let's look at that first guideline that I mentioned, manufacturing at an optimal operating point. We can see the energy intensity plotted versus production pack fine. And in this curve, you can see there is a energy intensity, minimum energy intensity. So we designed the resources so the production time at minimum energy intensity coincides with the customer output. We choose an output resources according to the production requirements. We operate the resources at ideal production rating and avoid oversizing the resources as a safety concern. The example here is a wave soldering machine that has a capacity utilization of 55% and has an energy intensity of 110 watt hours. And if the line had doubled its pack time, this would cut it in. Another guideline that we talked about is the guideline 2, reducing energy demand under normal operating conditions by technical improvements. The examples could be replace inefficiency rise, replace slab lasers, use of energy savings hydraulic oils. The measure is to use up-to-date equipment facilities, replace processes possibly, use energy efficiency operating supplies, reactive power compensation, and training of the employees efficient use of energy. So these are sometimes maybe referred to as behavior changes. Illustration we see here in a demand profile and the energy demand profile the robot shows an increase in energy demand within normal operating caused by inappropriate programming. And the energy wasted active remaining in the position of the robot waiting for the next working assignment instead of a break. So here's one example of the data logging power trends and demand trends use. Another example is we have the power consumption of two very similar electric furnaces, but the demands differ by a factor of 5. The average of the first has 9.1 kW. The average on the second, similar furnace, has 1.96 kW. The frequency of on-off of the first one is higher. And the average, the maximum demand peaks at over 25 kW. Where the second one with an average of 1.96 period of more than 1 minute at about 1.5 kW of sample. So out of 4 minutes, more than 1 minute at that standby at a power that's about 75% of the average power. This is the opportunity. The fourth guideline that I've illustrated today is energy recovery. It's guideline 5. Using energy several times if possible within the same process. The example would be energy recovery from a lift drive in a high bay warehouse. The measures would be using industrial waste heat, using heat recovery accumulators, using heat pumps for higher energy gains, or recovery of breaking energy or breaking systems, much like we see in automotive industry today. The consequence of reduction of internal thermal loads, as well as use of waste heat for environmental control in the factory, are shown here. So we have opportunities for both the water storage, hot water storage, as well as air heat exchangers. The third step that we have is energy management projects that we'd like to look at some case studies. And this is really the most important part of my presentation. Let's look at a production plant. This is a test facility in students from the United States go to for a two-week period for validation of their approach. The production is a front bumper of a car, automobile. It's made of 5 parts, and the production occurs in 4 production steps. The calculation energy density demonstrates the effect of the product-related approach. The first step is stamping. The second manufacturing step is hydraulic pressing. And the third and fourth, well, spot welding and gas welding. And we look at the energy intensity below each one, stamping as an energy intensity of 24 watt-hours, whereas the hydraulic press represents 51% is 1,267 watt-hours. Spot welding is 440, gas welding is 744. So the total energy intensity of this four-step process making a bumper, front bumper, is 2,465 kilowatt-hours. So the 65% of the here to the strip crawls. And finally, at the back of the farm, in the town, where we have exhaust heat recovery opportunities and heat pumps and thermal storage. To provide you with additional information, this slide gives a presentation that I made for the Tennessee Energy Education Initiative, and I welcome you to view that presentation if you're interested in more details. Likewise, this slide on the value stream mapping and how to visualize more online leadership and organizational transformations is presented for you. And as soon as I see that on the screen, okay, here we are. And so this is an example of value stream mapping and organizational transformations. So not only can you do the lean and energy value, but you can also allow that education process to transform the organization, providing So all of these go hand in hand. Here's a reference, a website, a YouTube video. And finally, this is a slide for mapping your values. It is actually a YouTube. So you can see a training program where instead of using the electronic value stream mapping, one might first start with a whiteboard, post-its, and start the process. And the advantage of the electronic value stream mapping, you can take a photograph of a whiteboard and it creates the electronic version based on what you see in this example. So this is a video on YouTube from the Society of Manufacturing Engineers. And with that, that concludes my brief presentation with a slide from the super root plant here in that produces automotive cars, supercars, where our Purdue University has a small office embedded in the manufacturing plant where I reside. With that, I think I've gone over my time limit, Tony. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your time. I'll take this video.